It is a rainy Monday morning here in the commercial state. Good morning, and you are watching the Super Screen TV News at 10. I am Kiruka Ibe, and now looking at the stories and the reports making the rounds. President Muhammadu Buhari has promised to continue to work tirelessly to promote, protect, and preserve a united, peaceful, prosperous, and secure Nigeria. The president, who made the promise in his national broadcast to mark the nation's 58th independence anniversary, said he is committed to ensuring that Nigeria became a country where all, irrespective of background, could aspire to succeed. Taking a look at the nation's journey in the past 58 years, the president said Nigeria had come a long way, even if the journey had not ended. He also lauded and remembered the nation's founding fathers, who he said labored so hard and sacrificed so much to build and bequeath a nation like Nigeria.
Hello, Nigerians. Today is a day of celebration and solemn reflection. It is the anniversary of the day Nigerians realized one of the most cherished of human desires, the desire for freedom. We therefore give thanks to and remember our founding fathers, who labored so hard and sacrificed so much to build and bequeath to us this wonderful nation. It is our duty to consolidate this great legacy. On this first October date, and on the eve of the start of the general election cycle, we should do well to reflect on what bind us together and the great strengths our diversity bestows on us. Ours is an ambitious nation, and as citizens, we have every right to look forward to the future with confidence and optimism, which are well-founded considering where we find ourselves today. There has been a steady improvement in the security situation in the Northeast. We remain committed to ending the crisis and make the Northeast safe for all. Our thoughts and prayers are always with the victims of Boko Haram's atrocities and their families. I want to assure you that as president, I will continue to work tirelessly to promote, protect, and preserve what really matters: a united, peaceful, prosperous, and secure Nigeria, where all, irrespective of background, can aspire to succeed. Thank you. I wish you a memorable independence celebration.
Addressing Nigerians there, the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, President Muhammadu Buhari. And on the other news, the Nigerian Labour Congress has suspended its ongoing nationwide strike following promises by the federal government to reconvene the Tripartite Committee on National Minimum Wage on October 4th. The NLC President, Ayuba Waba, who disclosed this to journalists, said that the labour action was suspended to enable the Tripartite Committee hold its crucial meeting and conclude its works. The organized labor had embarked on the strike after a 14-day ultimatum to the federal government for failing to come out with its own figure on the new minimum wage. The three labor unions had demanded 65,500 naira as new minimum wage for workers, while the private employers and some state governors were proposing 25,000 naira.
We have received a firm and formal invitation to a reconvened meeting of the Tripartite Committee scheduled for 4th and 5th of October 2018. We demanded that this shall be the final session of the committee's assignment and that a final report will then be submitted to Mr. President immediately. In order to avail the committee the necessary conducive environment to hold this crucial meeting and conclude its work, organized labor has, after obtaining the mandate of their necessary organs, decided to suspend The ongoing warning strike will effect from today, Sunday, 30th September 2018. And appreciation goes to you all who have actually been with us in the process of the struggle to actualize the minimum wage, and also within the period the warning strike have lasted. We urge all unions and our state council to continue to maintain high level of mobilization and readiness until this struggle for a reasonable minimum wage is actually achieved. We want to thank you immensely, and importantly, Nigerians, because as I said, this is one issue that we need to put it behind us and also deliver on a new minimum wage for Nigerian workers.
And still talking on the minimum wage, the Socio-Economic Rights and Accountability Project, SERAP, has urged President Muhammadu Buhari to intensify his government's crackdown on corrupt money and recovery of other illicit wealth by public officials and institutions to fund the proposed 65,000 naira national minimum wage by the Nigerian Labour Congress, NLC. SERAP, in a statement by its Deputy Director Timothy Adewale, said the minimum wage of 18,000 naira for Nigerian workers stands in sharp contrast with outrageous illegal salaries and allowances of high-ranking public officials who continue to enjoy lavish lifestyles with impunity. Adewale said having an exploited labor force will also exacerbate incidents of bribery, petty corruption, and undermine access of marginalized sectors of the population to essential public services such as water, health, and education. The director urged the president to stop former governors from receiving double pay and life pensions as seven senators and ministers. Away from that, now President Muhammadu Buhari has accepted the resignation of the Minister of Women Affairs, Aisha Alhassan. According to reports, the president directed the Minister for State, Trade and Investment, Aisha Abubakar, to take over Alhassan's former ministry. Alhassan says she received with shock and dismay her disqualification from the governorship contest, adding that no reason was given for it. You will recall that Alhassan tendered her resignation Saturday following her disqualification from the governorship race of Taraba State by the All Progressives Congress, APC. Ahead of the 2019 general elections, two global election watchdogs, the International Republican Institute, IRI, and the National Democratic Institute, NDI, have lamented the delay in finalizing the legal framework for the 2019 elections. The group charged the National Assembly and executives to ensure the timely passage of the amendment to the Electoral Act 2010. Speaking at a joint news briefing in Abuja, NDI Regional Director Central Europe Robert Benjamin said despite noticeable improvements in the electoral process, the delay in the release of forms for the general elections remain a pressing challenge.
Numerous positive developments have occurred since the 2015 elections that enhanced today's electoral environment in Nigeria. Some of these developments were noted in IRI and NDI's first pre-election statement in July. INEC has improved the voting process, notably through the introduction of continuous voter registration, adoption of simultaneous accreditation and voting, improvements to the secrecy of the ballot, and advancement of the smart card reader technology. Young people are motivated to participate in politics and to hold their representatives accountable through such initiatives as the Not Too Young to Run campaign. Citizens are deeply committed to democracy. Afrobarometer's 2017 survey found that 72% of Nigerians agree that democratic elections are the best means of choosing their country's leaders.
The team also advised the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, to take concrete measures to combat vote buying through voter education campaign and enforcement of laws against vote inducement. The delegation, however, noted that despite improvements to election administration in Nigeria, there are challenges that could limit the ability of Nigerians to experience a credible election process in 2019.
Recommendations for the federal government of Nigeria: provide sufficient and timely funds so that INEC and other electoral bodies can fulfill their responsibility as prescribed by law. Ensure the timely passage of the amendment to the Electoral Act 2010. Ensure that security services maintain the highest level of professionalism and impartiality in facilitating the electoral process. Refrain from actions that could be seen as motivated by partisan interests. Enable accredited observers and journalists to perform their work and protect the right of citizens to exercise their votes freely.
And the presidency says the outcome of the All Progressives Congress APC direct presidential primaries held over the weekend is a clear indication that President Muhammadu Buhari will emerge victorious in 2019 presidential elections. The president's senior special assistant on media and publicity, Garba Shehu, who disclosed this to journalists in Abuja, said the huge turnout of millions of registered party members at all voting centers had indicated that the president has an incomparable ability to reach out to people and mobilize votes. Shehu said the presidential primaries, which was held across the state with President Buhari as the sole aspirant, is a major boost to his success at next year's election. The presidential aide emphasized that beyond it being a victory for the party and the president, it is also a message to everyone that development and good governance is more important to Nigerians than divide and rule politics. Borno State Governor Kazim Shettima has endorsed Babagana Umar Zulum, the state's commissioner for reconstruction, rehabilitation and resettlement, to succeed him. According to reports, Shettima made the endorsement in Maiduguri while addressing all the governorship aspirants in the state ahead of the Sunday's governorship primaries of the All Progressives Congress APC. According to reports, Shettima had, within the last 1 month, held consultations with stakeholders, traditional rulers and party chieftains in order to get their views on the best candidate to succeed him. In 2015, Umar Zulum was appointed Commissioner for Reconstruction, Rehabilitation and Resettlement by Governor Shettima, a position he held to earlier this week when the Borno State Executive Council was dissolved. And still talking politics, the People's Democratic Party, PDP, has postponed its governorship primaries in Lagos State, Imo and Kano States indefinitely. National Publicity Secretary of the party, Kola Ologbondia, who made this public in a statement in Abuja, said the governorship primaries in other states taking part in the 2019 election will still be held throughout the country. Ologbondia said the attention of the National Working Committee of PDP has just been drawn to a rumor making the rounds that PDP's scheduled gubernatorial primaries has been postponed. The secretary added that the rumor about the postponement should be disregarded completely, adding that the gubernatorial primary election dates for Lagos, Kano, and Imo states will be announced soon. And the Ambode Mandate Support Group, AMSG, has sent a petition to the national chairman of the All Progressives Congress, APC, Adams Oshomole, over the endorsement of his opponent in the forthcoming governorship primary by the party leadership in the state. Chairman of the group, Akeem Suleiman, who made this known at a rally in Lagos to mobilize support for the second term bid of Ambode, said the action of the state chairman, Tunde Balogu, and members of the Governorship Advisory Council, GAC, in endorsing an aspirant as candidate of the party is a violation of the party's constitution. Suleiman said the support group could not fathom why the second term bid of the governor was being hindered. You will recall that Anthony Adofe, a member of the council, had on Saturday announced the endorsement of Babajide Sanwo-Olu to party members at a stakeholders' meeting at the party secretariat. The senator representing Ondo North Senatorial District, Ajayi Boroface, had allegedly escaped assassination in our headquarters of our local government area of the state. His special assistant, Claude Fakuye, who made this known to journalists, alleged that the suspected assailants were political thugs. Reacting, the Chief Press Secretary, CPS, to Governor Rotimi Akeredolu, Shegu Ajiboye, described the allegation as wicked, wondering how people should frame such blatant lie because of politics. Ajiboye cautioned Bureau of Affairs' group against raising unnecessary tension in the state ahead of the 2019 general elections. The Police Public Relations Officer, PPRO, for the state command, Femi Joseph, warned politicians against violence in the state, urging them to play the games according to the rule ahead of the 2019 polls. And now we'll take a short break, and when we return, we'll give you business-related stories. Stay with us.
Before they come, they're supposed to, you know, give us some information, notice, at least some, maybe a week or so. There was nothing like that.
Hunger is everywhere in Nigeria. People are dying every day, but Nigerian governments are keeping quiet. Housemen are killing people. Why?
It's not what we expected because of this old man that are leading us, and you people know, you are aware that these people are not the right people to lead us. These kind of people that are leading us here are black, people of black mind. They just care about themselves and their family.
You are fighting my business. Let me use guns. If I call it useless, I'm not a mistake.
Their businesses and do their businesses.
You're welcome back, and if you have just joined us, you are watching the Super Screen TV News at 10, and now talking business. The Central Bank of Nigeria, CBN, says the Nigerian economy recorded a total foreign exchange inflow of $6 billion in the month of July this year. The inflow of $6 billion, when compared with the $9.73 billion recorded in June this year, represents a decline of $3.73 billion, which is at 38.34% decline during the period. The Apex Bank says the inflow was recorded as a result of the continued stability in the foreign exchange market. According to CBN, it's promoted by improved dollar liquidity at the investors and exporters' windows of the market. The development, according to CBN records, is driving the exchange rate towards convergence at all segments of the market. The Petroleum and Natural Gas Senior Staff Association of Nigeria, PENGASAN, has highlighted the need to reform the nation's oil and gas industry in the bid to ensure economic development. PENGASAN, in its Independence Day message to Nigerians, said the government must resolve to address the gaps in the legal framework guiding operations and activities in the oil and gas industry through the passage of the Petroleum Industry Bill. According to the association, the Independence Day anniversary affords Nigerians the opportunity to review the progress made so far as a nation in its socio-economic and political journey, and to appreciate the sacrifice of thousands of forefathers who laid down their lives to make the country a breath of air for freedom and to keep Nigeria as one united and indivisible nation. And in the power sector, the Lagos Chamber of Commerce and Industry, LCCI, has called for the removal of import duty on all power supply equipment, such as solar panels, batteries, inverters, and wire mills, and other accessories, to enable the citizens to adopt individual power solutions. The president, LCCI, Babatunde Ruwase, speaking to journalists, said the power situation in the country had not witnessed any significant improvement since the handover of the power infrastructure to the new private owners in November 2013. Wase said to make progress in the sector, there is a need to de-emphasize the national grid model and concentrate on the promotion of the energy mix approach proposed by the Minister of Power, Housing and Works, Babatunde Fashola, adding that national grid model is too vulnerable to sabotage and other forms of disruption. And we'll take another short break, and when we return, we'll give you foreign and sports-related stories. Stay with us.